We want to graph y is greater than or equal to negative 2/3 x plus 4. To graph this, we want to graph the region where all the points would have ordered pairs that satisfy the given inequality. To do this, we treat this as a line, and we're going to graph y equals negative 2/3 x plus 4. This is actually going to be the boundary for the region that we'll end up shading. But there's one more thing to mention before we graph this line. Based upon the given inequality symbol, the line is either going to be dashed or solid. If we have less than or equal to or greater than or equal to, we're going to graph a solid line. Because of the equal part, the line is going to be part of the solution. But if we have less than or greater than, we'll make a dashed line because the line will not be part of the solution. So to graph this line, hopefully we recognize this as slope-intercept form of a line, or y equals mx plus b form, where b is the y-intercept and m is the slope. So to graph this line, we'll plot the y-intercept of positive 4. And then from here, we'll use the slope to determine additional points on this line. And I'll write the slope as negative 2 over 3, which remember is the ratio of the change of y to the change of x. So from the y-intercept, we'll go down 2 units and right 3 units. So down 2, right 3, down 2, right 3, and so on. So our borderline passes through these 3 points. And again, we already said it's going to be a solid line, so it's going to look something like this. So every point on this line is going to satisfy this inequality, but also every point on one side of the line is also going to satisfy the inequality. And because it says y is greater than or equal to negative 2x plus 3, if y is greater than or equal to, and we know y gets greater as we move upward along the y-axis, we're going to shade above the line. So every single point in the half plane above this line is part of the solution to this inequality, and therefore part of our graph. Let's go ahead and just verify this by checking a couple points. One point in the shaded region and one point in the region that's not shaded. For example, let's go ahead and test the point 3, 3, which would be this point here, which we're saying should be a solution. Let's also test the origin here, which we're saying is not going to satisfy the inequality. Okay, so if we substitute 3 for x and 3 for y, we would have 3 is greater than or equal to negative 2/3 times 3, which I'll write as 3 over 1, plus 4. Well, this simplifies, so we have 3 is greater than or equal to, this would be negative 2 plus 4, that's positive 2. That's true. And let's also test to make sure 0, 0 does not satisfy this inequality. So we would have 0 is greater than or equal to negative 2/3 times 0, that's going to be 0, plus 4. So we have 0 is greater than or equal to positive 4, which is not true, or it's false. So this verifies that we did shade the correct side of the line. And some textbooks do recommend that you always pick a test point to determine which side of the line to shade on. Meaning, if we tested the origin and it was false, this side here, we would shade the other side. And if we test a point that is true, like this point here, then we shade the same side of the line that we're on, or this region here. But if the inequality is solved for y, it's much easier just to ask whether you should shade above or below the line based upon the inequality. We'll take a look at some more examples in the next video.